Today I'm going to show you how to use complex numbers on the TI-nSpire CX CAS. Now remember, a complex number is defined usually in terms of the square root of negative 1. If I type into my calculator the square root of negative 1, I'm going to get this warning. It's going to say it's a non-real result, which is useful if you are trying to solve equations for real answers. If you see this, you'll know that there is not a real result for your answer. But if we want to figure out how to use complex numbers on the calculator, we can change that. So what we're going to do is go to your home page and go to Settings, which is number 5, and Document Settings. And here where it says real or complex, we're going to change it to rectangular. And make sure you make it the default so that it changes in all of your documents. So then we go back to our calculator page. So again, let me try that one more time. So if I try the square root of negative 1 this time, I should get an answer. I do, and I get I. And we know square root of negative 1 is defined to be I. So if I try to find the square root of negative 4, that should be 2i. Square root of 4 is 2. So if it's negative, I get 2i. Let me try one more. So do square root of negative 16, I get 4i. You can also do other operations with I. So for example, if I wanted to add two equations, say I wanted to add 7 plus 2i. Now the I itself, it's not the I here on your keyboard. Go to the pi, and then I is right there. It's the second one next to pi. So I can do 7 plus 2 pi plus 4 minus 6i. Sorry, it's a pi. 4 minus 6i. And if I hit enter, I get the answer, which is 11 minus 4i. You can also do division. If I hit control and the divided by sign, I'll get my fraction bar here. I can do 7 plus 2i over 4 minus 6i. And you get that, and it'll stay in a fraction form. If you hit control enter, it'll give you an estimate of those fractions. You can also multiply, so if you wanted to do anything such as, here I can do that same one, 7 plus 2i times 4 minus 6i, you can also do that calculation as well. You get 40 minus 34i. When you're done in complex mode, you may want to change your calculator back to regular mode. So make sure you can do that. You go back to menu, go back to home, go to settings, document settings. Make sure you're in the real or complex. You change it back to real. For some reason, you may want to keep it in complex mode, but make sure you do change it back because it will stay in that rectangular mode until you're done with it.